Greetings everyone, I am Bhargavi Trivedi and in this video tutorial we are going to discuss regarding Darwin's theory of natural selection, which is the part of paper BT101, The Living World, Unit 1, Origin of Life, Semester 1. So, Darwin, we know that he was a great artist. So, he was on a sea voyage. Okay. And he has been to many islands all over the world. So while he was traveling, he had many questions in his mind. He saw that there are so many varieties of species. Some species, they are very similar to each other. But as he was going on from one island to another, he saw that there are some variation in the same species. So he was constantly wondering that why it is so. So then he started thinking on this topic. And eventually he said that there is a natural selection that is going on into the nature. Now before understanding the natural selection, let's understand few terminologies so that you can understand his law that Darwin has given in a very simple way. Okay, so first understand that what is evolution. So evolution means the change that is continuously taking place over time. Okay, always remember evolution is not a single day process. It takes billions of years and eventually the species or whatever the things are, they change. So such type of phenomena is referred to as evolution. Now Darwin was on his journey and he was constantly seeing so many of the species. So some species have become extinct also, while there are some more species that are keep on coming on the main island. Okay. So he thought that how so much of changes are possible in nature. Okay, change doesn't take place on its own. So he thought that the evolution, or you can say the change that is taking place in the nature, is because of the natural process. That means in nature, something is happening because of that factor, or you can say external force, all the species cannot survive. But only those species who are able to survive, or you can say adapt under certain circumstances, or you can say the word fit for that particular area or particular environment, they are going to adapt themselves and then they are going to reproduce. Remember, it is necessary for the organism to reproduce. By just surviving or by just adapting in the nature, there are chances that it can become extinct. But once they start reproducing, then they can have their progeny for a longer period of time. So according to Darwin, there are some factors in the nature that are playing a vital role for the survival and the reproduction of the some species. So that's why this is happening. This type of selection of few species is happening because of the nature. That's why he termed this as natural selection. And he published his data in the book On the Origin of Species. And in that book, he has described two mechanisms. Okay, the main mechanism is of first is of descent with modification. And the second mechanism is the natural selection. We will understand descent with modification after we understand that what is natural selection. So let's have a quick look at what is natural selection. Now nature is going to select. So nature doesn't select randomly. So nature has some criteria on based on which it is going to select a particular species. So according to Darwin, it has set some criteria as factors. So here are some factors that Darwin has suggested because of which the particular species can evolve, or you can say can survive and reproduce, and it is getting selected by the nature. Okay, so like we will understand one by one in detail regarding each of these factors. So the first factor is rapid multiplication. Okay, so what do you understand by the word rapid? That means quick. Okay, so quick multiplication, that means if a organism wants to survive in the surrounding environment, then it needs to have more offspring. Okay, it needs to lay more offspring in nature. Even though, let's say, a particular species is having 1,000 offspring, okay, it is laying 1,000 offspring. Now, even though out of this 1,000, only 2 are surviving, and rest of the 998 individuals they are getting, they are dying. Okay, but these 2 can again reproduce, and they can again have their progeny that is still there existing in the nature. And also, let's talk about the division rate. Okay, so for example, plants produce thousands of seeds each year. But do you think that all the seeds they are going to get converted into the nature, converted into the plant form? No, not all the seeds. Maybe at least 10 or 12 seeds can get converted into the plant form. The same example is with the paramecium, or you can see codfish. Now, why it is so that not all the seeds or not all the eggs of the fish or any other individual they are able to survive? So the second important factor that Darwin has given is of limited environmental resources. That means not all the individuals they are going to have enough space and enough food if they want to survive and if they want to reproduce. So, as there are more population in nature, so they all are going to require more space and more food. But it is not that the planet Earth is going to get expand like this and they will have n number of resources. No, it is not so. Our planet Earth and our universe remains constant. So, individuals, then they are going to compete for limited resources. Okay. So what are the limited resources in the nature? They are going to compete for the food, they are going to compete for the water, they are going to compete for the spaces, and they are compete for the mates. That means mating process. Okay. Now only those individuals who can survive or who can compete and who can win the battle, they are going to survive in the nature. Okay. So, even though they are having competition, but there are different types of competition that is existing in nature. So, we say that they are struggling for existing in this universe, or you can say on this planet, for the resources that are limitedly available. So, first of them is the intraspecific struggle. That means struggle between the species. As you can see that there are 2 pairs. That means they are of same species. So they are fighting, or you can say they are struggling for the resources. Then another word is interspecific struggle. That means the battle between the different species. As you can see here, this is the crocodile and this is the cheetah. So they both are different species and they are fighting for the, they fight for the food. Okay. Because again, food is also a limited resource that is available in the nature. Okay, this is the third important one, is the environmental struggle. So there is extreme heat, or you can say sometimes extreme cold, drought, or other such conditions that nature is going to impart on the species, and only those species who can survive in this, they are going to flourish in the nature. Now, one of the example is that flood. Flood is moving, you cannot control flood, okay? Now suddenly there will come a flood and it can kill 1,000 of species, or you can say 1,000 of species that were already staying in the water reservoir body. So this environmental struggle is not under the control conditions. Now, of course, there are some changes that are taking place in the body, but there are again certain calamities that is not under the control. Okay, the next one is once they have, like, they are struggling for it, then the next thing is variation and adaptation. Now, this is the most important thing you have to understand when you are learning Darwin's theory or Darwin's law of natural selection. So basically, let's assume a condition in which there is a tree over here. Okay, and let's say the birds. Okay, let's say I'm giving you the simple example. Let's say there were birds that were feeding on this on the branch, on the insects that were present on this branches. Now birds, so let's say there were initially 80 birds, okay, but now because of the mating and all, the bird population has become 200. Okay, so now this tree is not enough to survive this vast increase in the number of birds. So what they will do, that there will be certain variation. For example, variation, the beak part, okay? The beak that is used to feed the insect that are present on this branch is very different if they want to feed the insects that also stay on the trunk. So let's assume a woodpecker. So if you see the beak of the woodpecker, it is very different, okay? So they will have those birds, okay, these birds will try to vary themselves, okay? So they will try to change something so that they can also feed on the insects that are present over here by changing the shape of the beak. And also, if you see the ground part, then there are some insects that are also available over here. So again, if they want to eat the insects that are present over here, then they want a beak like this. Okay, I'm really sorry for my drawing. So the beak needs to be like this so that they can eat. So basically what they are doing is they are varying the shape of the nature, and eventually they are adapting to those conditions. Okay, so there will be no competition, or you can say that there is a split. There is a split in their nature, which is because of the variation and adaptation. Okay, this is the example of the Darwin finches that you already know. Okay, the next part is survival of the fittest. That means the natural selection. Now, as we have seen that there are changes that is taking place in the beak part of the animal, or you can say bird. Okay, so the bird that they are going, those birds that have varied, they can only survive in the nature. For example, here I have given you the example of the giraffe. Now in nature, we have long neck giraffe also, medium neck giraffe also, and short neck giraffe also, okay? So short neck giraffe, they will die because they won't be able to have the food. So those traits will not be passed on to the next upcoming generations. And the long neck giraffe, they will be able to produce their progeny having the long neck itself, okay? And this short neck giraffe, they cannot survive, so they cannot produce the progeny. And that's why we have nowadays giraffe with the long neck and not with the short neck. Okay, so ultimately this is referred to as natural selection, because nature is selecting based on which of the factors, based on the sources, and on the base of the limited resources, the organisms are competing. Third is, once they have competed, or let's say they have some variation and adaptation, okay? So once they are having some variation and adaptation in them, they will be able to produce their more progeny, and they will be selected by the nature. So we say that it is the survival of the fittest. Then the next is inheritance of the useful variation. Okay, once they are long neck, so they will going to that reproduce, they are going to reproduce and they will have the offspring. So their progeny, they are going to inherit that long neck. So whatever the variation of that long neck, or you can say the, as we understand of the beak was there, they, it is going to pass on to the next progeny. And that's why we say that that variation was useful and it was inherited to the progeny. And ultimately, the last one is that it will result into the formation of new species. Now, before discussing that, let's just understand the word speciation. That means given under given time, and natural selection leads to the accumulation of changes that differentiate groups from one another, such that a new species may arise. Okay. For example, as we have seen, example of dark finches, or you can say beak of the bird. Okay. So eventually, the beak of the bird will so much change that ultimately it will result into the formation of a species that is new as compared to the original species. Okay, so that concept is known as the speciation. Remember that new species came from the pre-existing one only. But why we say that it is a complete new species? Because now it has its own way of competing. It has its own way of, it has its own way of feeding and all, and that's why we say that it is the new species. Let's take an example of insecticide resistance. Now we know that the insecticides, that means some type of chemical that kills the insect. Now we were excessively applying the insecticides, but there were few insects that were not getting killed by this insecticide. Okay, so they are good, they may have developed certain kind of resistance. Okay, now this resistant micro, or this resistant insect, is going to produce more number of progeny. Okay, so whatever the changes that took place inside the insect that was not killed, they are going to pass on to the into their offspring. Okay, so let's say they had some gene that was getting modified. So that gene was passed on to their offspring. Because of that gene that was passed, now they too are able to resist this pesticide, or you can say insecticide. So now, even though no matter how much insecticide you are going to apply, it is not going to kill those insects. And we say that they have become resistant. Okay. So basically, there are some changes that is taking place inside the organisms, and they are passed on to the new generation, and those organisms that can reproduce, and we can say that the nature is selecting it. If such resistance was not developed, then these insects would not have been possible to survive in this environment, and they might have become extinct. Now, let's summarize it. Then in natural selection, the main thing is that the organisms that are best adapted to the environment have a better chance of surviving and reproducing. And let's talk about another part that I told you in the beginning, that is descent with modification. Descent with modification is simply giving birth to the individuals which have already acquired the new characteristics. Okay, so we all are coming from the common ancestors. But when there are some changes in the ancestors that are passed on to their offspring. Now imagine if they are not passed on to the another offspring, when the another offspring is born. And remember, if we have the same characteristic, for example, if we have the tail, then what? So what it tries to say that there are certain modifications that are taking place in a particular species, and when they reproduce, they are going to give that modification to their offspring. Okay, so that's why they say that the newborn or the new descendant is having that modified characteristic. That is the main thing of this descent with modification. If there was no descent with modification, then there has been no diversity in this entire universe. Okay, so this modification that is carried over by generation after generation, we will have the diversity of species. This is the main reason that why in this universe or why on this planet Earth there is so much of diversity in the same insects you see in the United States or you see in the India or you see in the European countries. Okay, this is the same insect, but they will have certain difference of few characteristics among them. Okay, this is was the main theme of Darwin. Okay, this is the main difference between Darwin's and Lamarckism. Okay, and here are some of the reference book that I have suggested you. I request you to please go through it because it will help you in understanding the topic in a much better way. Okay, and if you have more questions, then please email me your questions on bhargavatrivedi.lgis@indianinstitutes.edu. I will be more than happy to help you. Okay, thank you and bye for now.